Well, Australia is set to have the best seat in the House tomorrow morning when an asteroid, potentially worth billions of dollars, passes by Earth. Professor Fred Watson joins us now to talk all things asteroids. But first, earlier tonight, Professor, there was quite an extraordinary event in Russia. It was a meteor blast that's left several hundred people injured. Is this unusual? What's happened there?
Yeah, a curtain raiser for tomorrow's event, although probably completely unrelated to it. What seems to have happened is a meteor, a small asteroid essentially, has entered the Earth's atmosphere above these cities in southern Russia and exploded and caused a lot of damage to things like windows, and the shockwave has injured, as you said, hundreds of people. Five people hospitalised.
Is this an unusual event, particularly in a built-up area?
Yes. I mean, these things probably do happen from time to time and usually go completely unnoticed because they're over the ocean or something like that. But over a city, then, of course, it attracts a lot of attention and causes damage.
Now, Professor, DA14, just how big is this? How significant an event is this for us?
This is a much bigger object, DA14, which will fly by the Earth at about 6:30 our time tomorrow morning. Looking at this asteroid's eye view, you can see that it's tumbling through space. It's about 45 metres across. It will be closest to Australia when it's at its closest approach, which is why we'll get the best view, and then recede off into space, coming to within 27,700 kilometres of the Earth, or 27,681 kilometres. But the object will actually pass within the ring of geostationary satellites, which is what we all rely on for communications and internet and GPS.
Now, it sounds like a long way away, of course, 27,000 kilometres, but it's rarely been seen that a meteor or an asteroid of this size has come within Earth, is that correct?
That's right. It's the closest approach of a body this size since we've known about these things, and by that I mean since we've been able to detect them. So it's quite an unusual event. But of course, in this business, a miss is as good as a mile. This is not going to enter the atmosphere. It's not going to do any damage.
Professor, one of the other things I wanted to ask you about, there's been speculation that the asteroid could be worth plenty of money. I've heard figures upwards of $185 million. How can a piece of rogue rock be worth such an astronomical figure?
Exactly. It's all about the minerals and metals, precious metals, that we think are locked up in asteroids, because the asteroids are actually the kind of raw material of the solar system. And there are at least two companies who have been set up recently in order to look at the possibility of mining asteroids, and that's actually a good news story for all of us, because if you're going to mine an asteroid, it might well give you the potential one day to deflect one that is on a collision course with the Earth.
If need be. It sounds like the stuff of movies, doesn't it? Mining an asteroid, it's possible?
Yeah, it is. The technology is there. It's just raising the money that's the big issue. But if you're going to make a profit from it, then that's the way it will go.
Now, you mentioned the best view of this will be from Australia. How good will the view be? Will you be getting up to watch?
It's not good enough to get me up out of bed. It's an object that's quite faint and will be difficult to see. It's below the Southern Cross very early in the morning, about 6:30 in the morning. You really need binoculars or a sizable telescope to see it, and of course you've got to know exactly where to point them. But our telescope in Coonabarabran, the one that's just survived a bushfire, will actually be observing it in the small hours of the morning.
So have a sleep in and watch it on replay,
that's
perhaps.
That's the way to go.
Professor Fred Watson, thanks very much for joining us.
It's a great pleasure. Thanks.
Excellent. Thank you very much.